Hello and welcome to St. Peter and St. Paul. It's good to have you with us worshiping God together. You can find a bulletin on our website at peterandpaul.org, which will have all the prayers and the music so that you can join in this service. So let's start with our first hymn, Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Trusting him, I shall not fear, for the Lord defends.
Let us pray. Let your continual mercy, O Lord, cleanse and defend your church. And because it cannot continue in safety without your help, protect and govern it always by your goodness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us now hear from the Word of God.
A reading from Genesis. The same night Jacob got up and took his two wives, his two maids, and his 11 children, and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. He took them and sent them across the stream, and likewise everything that he had. Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When the man saw that he did not prevail against Jacob, he struck him on the hip socket, and Jacob's hip was put out of joint as he wrestled with him. Then he said, "Let me go, for the day is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So he said to him, "What is your name?" And he said, "Jacob." Then the man said, "You shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have striven with God and with humans and have prevailed." Then Jacob asked him, "Please tell me your name." But he said, "Why is it that you ask my name?" And there he blessed him. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, "For I have seen God face to face, and yet my life is preserved." The sun rose up upon him as he passed Penuel, limping because of his hip. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's psalm is printed in your bulletin. We will read it responsively by half verse. Hear my plea of innocence, O Lord. Give heed to my cry.
Listen to my prayer.
Which does not come from lying lips.
Let my vindication come forth from your presence.
Let your eyes be fixed on justice.
Weigh my heart, summon me by night.
Melt me down. You will find no impurity in me.
I give no offense with my mouth as others do.
I have heeded the words of your lips.
My footsteps hold fast to the ways of your law.
In your paths my feet shall not stumble.
I call upon you, O God, for you will answer me.
Incline your ear to me and hear my words.
Show me your marvelous loving kindness.
O Savior of those who take refuge at your right hand from those who rise up against them.
But at my vindication, I shall see your face.
When I awake, I shall be satisfied. Beholding your likeness.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred, according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Have you ever had one of those really frustrating days? You know, one of those days where your alarm clock doesn't wake you on time? Then the shampoo bottle runs dry, or when your toothbrush breaks in two, and then you pour yourself a bowl of cereal only to realize that you don't have any milk, or you find out far too late that the only coffee you have is decaf, and you wonder what sort of day awaits you. Are you ever inclined just to go back to bed? Of course, some people don't go back to bed on a day like that, but they let their frustrations out against their coworkers or their students or their customers. Have you ever met one of those people? Have you ever been one of those people? Well, I would guess that this describes most of us at some time in our lives. Of course, some days are more serious than the scene that I just described. Sometimes our frustration comes from losing a job, or losing a friend, or losing a loved one. Plans for school this year open up a pile of questions for parents and students and teachers. This whole year has been racked with frustration and uncertainty. What happens in our relationship with God when things are frustrating, where life or God hasn't measured up to our expectations, where we are left feeling discouraged? Well, some act as if there's nothing that they can do, and they give up. Others turn away from God in disgust and walk away. Others, however, take a different path. Instead of giving up on God or walking out on God, they engage God. They ask God, "What is going on? Where are you in all of this? What do you want me to do? How do you want me to grow in the midst of this?" They press God for clarity and direction. They call on God to be true to His covenant with us. While some give up, and others walk out, these people wrestle with God. Especially when we feel on our own or without connection or support, engaging life in difficult times saps our energy and challenges our hope. And yet, when you wrestle with God, hanging on to God with both arms, God will bless you. Now, today's Old Testament reading is one of my favorite passages in Scripture. I know, I've got a lot of favorites, but this is one of my favorite passages in Scripture. This is the story of Jacob wrestling with God and receiving God's blessing in the process. Jacob is one of the first patriarchs in the Old Testament. Jacob is Abraham's grandson and the father of the 12 tribes of Israel. Jacob started out, however, as something of a cheat and a scoundrel. Among his exploits, he cheated his brother Jacob out. Jacob cheated his brother Esau out of the inheritance of their father. So later in life, when Jacob seeks mercy from his brother, he discovers that Esau will meet him the following day. Esau and 400 of Esau's men. In fear of Esau's revenge, Jacob divides up his extended household, his livestock, his possessions, his servants. He sends lavish gifts on ahead for Esau to receive in advance. And then Jacob waits for daybreak, all alone by the river Jabbok. Jacob is alone. He is without support or defense. He is vulnerable before the approach of his cheated brother the following day. Then, unexpectedly, we read that Jacob wrestled with someone until daybreak. This verse seems to jump out without warning, especially since we just heard that Jacob was alone by the river. Jacob is wounded in his hip from this wrestling match, but he won't let go. Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you give me your blessing." Then his mysterious opponent names Jacob Israel, a name that means one who wrestles with God. And then he blesses Jacob. Now, I find this such a powerful passage. We often think of God either as too quaint to be taken seriously or too fearful to be encountered. But rarely do we think of wrestling with God. And yet, when you wrestle with God, God will bless you. Now, wrestling with God comes in many forms. We wrestle with questions of belief and doubt. We wrestle with our ability to trust God. We wrestle with how to find the right thing to do. And often in our wrestling match, we become more and more aware of our own faults and weaknesses, the problems left to fester in our blind spots, the old habits of living that run us into trouble again and again. And yet, there is God wrestling with us. The great spiritual mystics of the Christian faith recognize a pattern in this wrestling with God. Teresa of Avila, or John of the Cross, or Evelyn Underhill all write about the spiritual life with God. Underhill writes about five phases of the spiritual life, starting with awakening, the realization that God is there and that God seeks an active and deeper relationship with us. This leads later to illumination, to learning to know more about God, learning to know God more closely. And ultimately, this leads to a unifying experience with God, a deep and powerful and intimate connection with God. However, there are two other phases that are interspersed along this path. Before illumination comes an important preparatory phase, purification, or to use a more traditional term, purgation. Purgation is that great house cleaning of the soul, kind of like when an alcoholic clears all the booze out of the house, or when a teenager gives up a circle of friends that has become destructive and abusive. Purgation strips away all the false supports that we cling to, money or comforts or stability, in order to open ourselves to God. And before that deepest connection with God comes a sense of God's distance, often called the dark night of the soul. In the dark night of the soul, we learn to give up those feelings that were only counterfeits to God, even those inner feelings that we cling to and yet that are ultimately not truly God. We may find ourselves like Jacob, without friends or family or riches, vulnerable and clear that only God is our true support. Purgation and the dark night of the soul are a kind of wrestling with God. The mystics went through it. Mother Teresa went through it. Even Jesus wrestled with God the Father in the Garden of Gethsemane. But he was strengthened enough to move forward in his journey through the cross to resurrection and new life. Wrestling with God leads to God's blessings. These purifying steps that the Christian mystics write about renew our minds and free our spirits to see God more clearly in our lives. No longer distracted by our riches or our worries, we see how God is taking action to bless us. When we know only God and only truly God, then we find that peace and joy that nothing can take away. I can think of some people that I know who are going through experiences like this, and times in my own life when I've gone through experiences like this. I can think of a friend of mine who is in the midst of chaotic chaos in his chaotic conflict in his family, and yet he is determined to stand firm both against injustice and in favor of healing. He is in a mighty wrestling match, and in the midst of it, God is working a mighty blessing for him and for his family. In many conflicts, some respond with hatred, and others simply walk away, shut down and cut off. Others hang on and say, "This is worth it. We are going to do what it takes to work this out." Now, it is not always perfect. Often we still carry with us the scars and the wounds of those hard times, the way that Jacob walked away with a limp. But I have seen people blessed when they hold on to God with both hands and say, "I will not let you go until you give me your blessing." They find healing by God's grace, and God blesses them. Are you going through a period of wrestling with God? How might God be calling you to take down the barriers that block you from a deeper relationship with God? What in your life has taken the place of God? What has become higher priority than God in your life? Or perhaps you feel faithful but still sense God's absence. How might you discover the light of God's presence despite this sense of darkness? In what new place might you discover God at work in your life? What part of your life have you decided is off-limit to God's blessings? Because you might be surprised at what God can do. Listen to what God did for Jacob after Jacob wrestled with God. God named Jacob Israel, one who wrestles with God. And Jacob carried his injury with him, but he received God's blessing as he limped past Penuel. Also, see if you can hear the language that Jesus picks up in his parable of the prodigal son. This is Genesis chapter 33, just following the reading that we heard today. Now Jacob looked up and saw Esau coming, and 400 men with him. So he divided the children among Leah and Rachel and the two maids. He put the maids with their children in front, then Leah with her children, and Rachel and Joseph last of all. He himself went on ahead of them, bowing himself to the ground 7 times until he came near his brother. But Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept. When Esau looked up and saw the women and children, he said, "Who are these with you?" Jacob said, "The children whom God has graciously given your servant." Then the maids drew near, they and their children, and bowed down. Leah likewise and her children drew near and bowed down. And finally Joseph and Rachel drew near, and they bowed down. And Esau said, talking about the gifts that Jacob had sent him, Esau said, "What do you mean by all this company that I have met?" Jacob answered, "To find favor with my Lord." But Esau said, "I have enough, my brother. Keep what you have for yourself." Jacob said, "No, please, if I find favor with you, then accept my present from my hand. For truly to see your face is like seeing the face of God, since you have received me with such favor. Please accept my gift that is brought to you, because God has dealt graciously with me, and because I have everything that I want." So he urged him, and he took it. Then Esau said, "Let us journey on our way, and I will go alongside you." When Jacob wrestled with God, he found blessing and even healing in his relationship with the brother that he had cheated. When you and I wrestle with God, we also find blessing and healing in our lives. So hold on with both hands and join with Jacob in telling God, "I will not let you go until you give me your blessing." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh, sorry. Let us say together the Apostles' Creed. The Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son.
With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified.
He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us join together in the prayers of the people.
In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors.
And for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Rob, Don, and Paul, our bishops, Tom and Elisa, our priests, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God and His church.
For the special needs and concern of this congregation. For Alice, James, Lauren, Margaret Ann, Susie, Tim, and Bella, and those affected by COVID-19. And for our military personnel who are deployed in harm's way, especially for our parish family members, Alex, Rylan, and Sam. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. Especially we thank you that despite the building being closed, the church is not. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
And praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. We pray especially for John Lewis, for Herman, and for Karen. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
Who put their trust in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins.
Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
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 The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you. Welcome to St. Peter and St. Paul. It's great to have you with us online. We continue to pray for the day when we can have you with us more in person. Our mission is growing disciples of Jesus Christ, and we continue in that mission, even if perhaps a little hindered by the coronavirus. We believe that God has a vision for us as a Christian community, empowered by the Holy Spirit, active in the worship of God, discipleship for all ages, serving Christ and the world. And that mission continues as we pursue that vision. We have a virtual coffee hour after the service today, so if you can find the link in the email that was sent to you, that will get you to the virtual coffee hour so that you can say hello to your friends If you did not receive an email and would like to be on our email list, you can find a link for that on the homepage of our website. Also, we continue our service of Compline, a very brief set of prayers from the Book of Common Prayer at the end of the day. These are held at 8 o'clock in the evening, Sunday through Thursday night, and they're led by members of our parish. And I hope that you can join us for Compline as well. Our plans for regathering are continuing. We're doing some preparation. We're doing some training of those who will serve as hosts. That's kind of like ushers and greeters, combination of ushers and greeters that will help people as they come in. We don't have a date yet. Our cases in Georgia and in Cobb County continue to be very high. They're not increasing quite as dramatically as they were earlier in the month, but they're still very high. So we're going to watch those numbers very closely and continue to consult and pray about when the time is best for us to start phase one gathering. So please keep us all in your prayers and keep in your prayers the rest of our community as well. And walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, for you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection.
We await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things and long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father,
you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ,
and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood.
Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart
through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.